Hello everyone, how are you? This is my second video on my VR series, so let's begin. When it comes to the pre-production, I think it's useful to make a list of all the things you need to do and how much time you have to accomplish them. For virtual reality experiences, it is very helpful to know the three animation workflow, which will serve as a starting point, with some modifications depending on what is needed for your project. An important part of the pre-production is organizing the tasks and the specific actions that we have to do. It is useful to separate tasks into groups, the ones you can make simultaneously and the ones that need a previous step. For example, you can't make the animatic before writing the script, but you can test different software while writing the script if you are still unsure which one to use, which is actually what I did. You can break the list down first in months and then in what you're going to do each day. When making this video, I found so many helpful resources about pre-production, planning, and scheduling a 3D short film. I recommend get acquainted with the straight ahead hero shots and layering process and choose whatever fits your project better. During the pre-production, I wrote the script and also I tested the workflow. First, I tested three different software to see how difficult it was to make a 360-degree video in this free software. Do I need to know some coding? Are there any tutorials? How's the render process for the underwater effect as well, and how long it takes? How long the final render will take approximately? At what quality it could be rendered, taking into account the computer used? And I added the estimated render time to the project schedule. First, I tested Unreal Engine, but rendering 360-degree images was a bit tricky and the software didn't run smoothly in my computer. Then I tested Unity and the rendering process was fast, but when I tried making the underwater effect, I had some inconsistencies with the lighting, as you can see, and I had to animate the models in Blender and then import them in Unity. So I decided to go with Blender, even though the rendering was way slower and I had to come up with an underwater effect that was faster than the typical volumetric approach. After several attempts, I decided to use a mist pass, export as an XAR and make the underwater look in compositing. I'll show you how in another video. Because this is a virtual reality project, the first test will be about capturing 360-degree images, but you can test beforehand any challenging element in your project, an animation style, specific lighting, etc. After that, I had the opportunity to keep testing Blender when I made the animatic in 360 degrees. The idea behind this is to know at the beginning, is this project viable? Basically, I made a simulation of what the final project or certain elements of it will look like. I tested not only the 3D software, but the whole pipeline, 3D software, video editor, and uploading the video. To recap, in this stage, I tested different settings, frame resolutions, the passage from the 3D software to the final image editor, among others. After the pre-production, during the production, I also tested other things as the project progressed. I tested the composition, doing some blocking, tested the animation speed, etc. These tests are usually made in a lower resolution. I also made one still image of each scene to see the size of the objects, the color schemes, and the mist pass values. This pre-production list should include a detailed list of the 3D models you need to model or buy or get from 3D websites that offer free models if you are on a budget. I modeled some objects and I downloaded others and changed some of their materials. So once you've finished your script, read and highlight every object, character, effect that you need to create and put it on the list. Before modeling, along with your image references, you should definitely get some image reference for the overall look. Is it going to be realistic looking or non-photorealistic? Then how realistic or how stylized? If you're not good at drawing, you might struggle with the concept art, but you can Google images similar to what you're aiming for and even do a little collage. The reason I put the camera settings into this chapter is because I was at the beginning of the project when I chose my camera and render settings. So, how to capture 360 degree images in Blender? You have to be in Cycles. Choose panoramic as the camera type and equirectangular as the panorama type. Now, my output properties. Initially, the frame size was 2000 by 1000, but then I went with 3840 by 1920. And it will only be visible in camera view mode in render view. In virtual reality, a 2K frame size will not be the final resolution the viewer sees, as that resolution is spread over a 360 degree image and we only see a portion of it at a time. Also, the aspect ratio must be 2x1. You can Google some cheat sheets for this aspect ratio's usual sizes, but essentially it's twice as wide as it is tall. In Blender, you can't preview in 360 degree, but you can preview as a flat image in solid mode to see the camera speed or the speed of the elements, for example, which is what I did. Or you can use only a few samples and a lower resolution without changing the aspect ratio for a quick render in 360 degrees. Make sure the camera is always in the middle of the scenario, otherwise it will look like this. I already talked about the camera movement in the script in the previous video, but now let's see a bit more practical advices. First, you don't have to rotate the camera around because that's what the audience will do. You can move your camera up and down, left and right, or back and forward. After I rendered the image, these were my Adobe Premiere project settings. If the center of the image is off, you can change it in the editing software. I recommend a free plugin called Reframe for that. And these were my render settings for turning this flatty into a proper 360 degree video. I will talk about my settings a bit more in a future video, but there's not really much more than this though. And that's it for today's video. We still have two videos to go to complete this VR series, where I'm going to talk about lighting, the underwater effect in compositing, and my rendering workflow. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!